عارف اللي هو المجموعة بتاعت عملنا. خليك لو نبدأ دلوقتي، بس هم أبدأ ولا منتظر عشان ابعت لهم اللينك؟ انت عارف المجموعة هذه
اول ده
انتظر عنه
بسيط.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. إن شاء الله تعالى in these few sessions we'll go through a book, two chapters of it إن شاء الله. And this book is by شيخ السلام تيمين رحمه الله. Is the voice is okay؟ الرأس بوتي. And it's called قاعدة عظيمة في الفرق بين عبادات أهل الإسلام والإيمان وعبادات أهل الشرك والنفاق. A great principle in the differences in عبادة in worship between the people of الإسلام والإيمان versus the people of الشرك and hypocrisy and نفاق. What's the difference in the عبادة between the people of الإسلام and الإيمان versus the people of shirk and nifaq and hypocrisy. It should be something very obvious. So this is a matter of aqidah, a matter of belief that we need to be upon. But it's a great book, and it talks about some of the issues that even some of the Muslims, they would imitate the ways of the people of shirk in matters of ibadah. He includes that in the book. But if we have time, inshallah ta'ala, we'll go through as much as we can, inshallah ta'ala. So as usual, we have to go through books, and this is the way the ilm or the knowledge should spread. And it's part of the, as even one of the early generations of Islam, he said, in the meaning of which, when someone does not teach from a book, it's something that is close to, they use the word al-kadhib or lying, but it's not considered to be like lying, but it's the truthfulness of ilm that it's passed on from one generation to the other through the books. It's not the most pleasant to many people. There's a difference between reminders and studying something. So when we study a subject, definitely we should go through the books of the people of Ahlul Ilm and to learn it and to convey it to others. And this is how we establish the deen in our hearts, and we are steadfast upon the deen of Allah facing these types of fitan. And the ilm and the knowledge, for us to gain the benefit of it, it can never be attained unless the hearts are seeking rewards from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the hereafter only, without any worldly benefit whatsoever. This deen is the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants from us to be sincere, to seek the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, and to follow the way the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. And we have in the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam the best example. And the ilm and the knowledge is the khashya, is the fear of Allah. And not just some information, but rather it's the fear of Allah. And the most important thing, of course, is matters of aqidah, matters of belief. And that we need to always repeat it and to be firm upon it and to convey it to others. So after praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and making salah on the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he mentioned a chapter saying في الفرق بين عبادات أهل الإسلام, the difference between the عبادات, the acts of worship of the people of Islam, والإيمان والهدى, guidance والتوحيد, the oneness of Allah سبحانه وتعالى in worship, and الإخلاص, sincerity, and العلم والشرع, the knowledge and the deen of Islam, المتبعين الأنبياء والمرسلين, those who follow the prophets and the messengers of Allah, versus the عبادات of the people of الشرك, associating partners with Allah, النفاق, hypocrisy, الجهل, ignorance, والضلال, deviation, والبدعة, innovation in the deen, من المشركين, from the مشركين, ومن ضاهاهم من مبتدعة أهل الملل, and from the مشركين and those who imitated them, from the مبتدعة, from the people of innovation, from the different sects of those who might be claimed to be Muslims and so on. So what's the difference and how to make sure that our ibadah is based on al-Islam or al-Iman and not based on the other ways of which is deviation. He says, فَعِبَادَاتُ الْمُسْلِمِينَ مَبْنِيَّةٌ عَلَىٰ أَصْلَيْنِ. The ibadat of the Muslimin is established on two foundations or two principles. And learning it and teaching it to our children and to be upon it and to have it when we are asked, when we have this in our heart, it's present in our heart. The first one, أنهم لا يعبدون إلا الله وحده لا شريك له. That they only worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He has no partners whatsoever in their ibadah. They worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. And the second thing is, وَأَنَّهُمْ يَعْبُدُونَهُ بِمَا أَمَرَ وَشَرَعَ لَهُمْ مِنَ الدِّينِ الَّذِي بَلَّغَتْهُ رُسُلُ عَنْهُ. That they worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded and legislated for them from the deen that the messengers of Allah conveyed to the people. فَهُمْ يَعْبُدُونَ اللَّهِ. So the people of Islam and Iman, they worship Allah. لا يشركون به شيئا. They do not associate partners with Allah. ويتقونه, and they are dutiful to Allah and protect themselves from sins. ويطيعون رسله كما أمرتهم الأنبياء بذلك. And they obey their messengers as the prophets commanded them to do so. And he mentioning it in the plural tense because this is how the deen of Islam from the time of Adam عليه السلام. To worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone and to follow the messengers alayhim as-salam, every nation according to their message. And the final messenger is Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, sent to all mankind. So the ibadah cannot be ibadah unless it has these two foundations. To worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, but it's easy to say in general terms. But as we see, the details of it has to go back to these two principles. So the ibadah sincerely for the sake of Allah and according to the way of the messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If we look into the ayat of the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about Nuh, إِنَّ أَرْسَلْنَا نُوحًا إِلَىٰ قَوْمِهِ أَنْ أَنذِرْ قَوْمَكَ مِنْ قَبْلِ أَنْ يَأْتِيَهُمْ عَذَابٌ أَلِيمٌ. Surah Nuh, that we sent Nuh alayhi salam to warn, أَنْ أَنذِرْ قَوْمَكَ, warn your people, مِنْ قَبْلِ أَنْ يَأْتِيَهُمْ عَذَابٌ أَلِيمٌ, before a painful punishment comes to them. And see how that the first thing is to warn the people. And it's not just to say to them all kinds of glad tidings. Warn your people before a punishment, a painful punishment, would come to them. This type of statement, many people, they don't like it. But this is how honesty the messengers of Allah are. They're honest with the people. There is harm, there is painful punishment is coming to them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala warned against the hellfire and he created the hellfire in the Jannah. So for a person to think that he is being kind to the people when he does not disturb them and doesn't tell them that warn yourself from a punishment from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that will come your way if you do not believe in him, right? He is actually deceiving them. And we talked about that many times because people will consider you as a betrayal to them if you know that is imminent danger coming their way and you don't warn them against it. So the worst thing ever is for someone to enter the hellfire. So how Nuh alayhi salam, he said to his people, an anzir qawmak, Allah conveyed, revealed to him, before a painful punishment comes. Qala ya qawmi inni lakum nadhirun mubin. He said, my people, I am to you a clear warner. أن يعبدوا الله واتقوه وأطيعون. أن يعبدوا الله, worship Allah, واتقوه, be dutiful to Allah, the taqwa of Allah with the details of the ibadah, وأطيعون, and obey me. So the two principles are mentioned there. Worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone and obey the messenger alayhi salam, and now he's warning his people, because if they don't do this, there's a painful punishment will come to them. And what happened to the people of Nuh? Those who disbelieved in him, and which is most of them, وَمَا أَمَنَ مَعَهُ إِلَّا قَلِيلٌ, only few accepted the message of Nuh alayhi salam, and the rest, they received the painful punishment. So it did not benefit them, because they arrogantly turned away from it. And he mentioned how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned about Hud and Salih and Shu'aib. All of them, they said, as it's mentioned in Surah Hud, the same statement, "U'budu Allah ma lakum min ilahin ghayru," worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you have no one worthy of worship except him. And he said about Al-Masih, Isa alayhi salam, in Surah Maryam, verse number 36. He said, "Ya bani Israel, u'budu Allah rabbi wa rabbakum." Isa alayhi salam said to Bani Israel, he was sent to Bani Israel, "Ya Bani Israel, u'budu Allah rabbi wa rabbakum," worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, my Lord and your Lord. "Innahu man yushrik billahi faqad harrama Allahu alayhi al-jannata wa ma'wahu an-nar." Indeed, the one that associates partners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah forbade on him the Jannah, and his abode and final place is the hellfire. وَمَا لِلظَّالِمِينَ مِنْ أَنصَارٍ, and the ظَالِمِين, the wrongdoers, they have no helpers whatsoever. So this is the mercy that the messengers of Allah had towards their people, inviting them to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and do not associate partners with Allah, and making the matter very clear and honest with them that Allah would forbid the Jannah on the person that associate partners with Allah, and his place will be the hellfire. وقال وإن الله ربي وربكم فاعبدوا هذا صراط مستقيم. And indeed, my Lord and your Lord is Allah, so worship him. This is صراط مستقيم. This is the straight path. And you see how the people of deviation and evil, they change this, and they affect the weak among the Muslims, those who would imitate them. They would remove from their way of speech and inviting and da'wah this warning against the hellfire. They make the religion just a way of life and different ways of doing things, and even wal'adhu billah can approve the kufr and the disbelief. And this is such a dangerous thing, and betraying the amana that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala entrusted this ummah with. And the messengers of Allah, they are the best example for all of us, how they were the best and the most kind and the most merciful towards their people, but they were firm upon the truth with the clear warning against what's waiting for them. And all the messengers, they said, فَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَأَطِيعُونَ, be dutiful to Allah, and وَأَطِيعُونَ, and obey me, obey the messengers. So the messengers, they have to be obeyed. وقال عن أمة محمد, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about the nation of أمة محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم, ويقولون آمنا بالله وبالرسول وأطعنا ثم يتولى فريق منهم من بعد ذلك وما أولئك بالمؤمنين. This is with regards to the hypocrites. They say we believe in Allah and the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, وأطعنا, and we are obedient. ثم يتولى فريق منهم, then a group of them turn away afterwards, وما أولئك بالمؤمنين, they are not believers. Why? Because they turned away from the belief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and his messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and the obedience of Allah and his messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah An-Nur, ayah number 51 and 52, إِنَّمَا كَانَ قَوْلَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ إِذَا دُعُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ لِيَحْكُمَ بَيْنَهُمْ أَنْ يَقُولُوا سَمِعْنَا وَأَطَعْنَا. Indeed, the speech of the believers, the statement of the believers, when they are invited to Allah and his messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to judge between them, that they would say سَمِعْنَا وَأَطَعْنَا, we listen and we obey. وَأُولَئِكَ هُمُ الْمُفْلِحُونَ, and they are the successful ones. وَمَنْ يُطِعِ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ وَيَخْشَى اللَّهَ وَيَتَّقِهِ فَأُولَئِكَ هُمُ الْفَائِزُونَ, and whoever obeys Allah and his messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he fears Allah and he shields himself from the punishment of Allah, they are the successful ones. So it mentions the obedience of Allah and his messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He says فَجَعَلَ الطَّاعَةَ لِلَّهِ وَالرَّسُولِ وَجَعَلَ الْخَشْيَةَ وَالتَّقْوَى لِلَّهِ وَحْدَهُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made the ta'a, the obedience to Allah and his messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he made the fear and the taqwa to Allah alone, not to Allah and his messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. As the ayah says, وَمَنْ يُطِعِ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ, whoever obeys Allah and his messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَيَخْشَ اللَّهُ, and he fears Allah alone, وَيَتَّقِهِ, and you have the taqwa of Allah alone, فأولئك هم الفائزون. They are the successful ones. You see how clearly the ibadah of the believers are, and the difference between Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the creator of the heavens and earth, nothing is the like of him, and the messengers of Allah, they are the best people, and they are to be obeyed because they convey what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to them. So their obedience is the obedience of Allah in principle. من يطع الرسول فقد أطاع الله. Whoever obeys the messenger, indeed he obeyed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And even subhanAllah, like this morning we're talking about the ayah, لقد كان لكم في رسول الله أسوة حسنة لمن كان يرجو الله واليوم الآخر وذكر الله كثيرا. Indeed you have in the Prophet, in the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم أسوة حسنة. The word أسوة in Arabic means one to follow, an example to follow. But the ayah says في رسول الله, you have in the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, not in the actions only, not in his speech only, no, you have in the being of the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام the example for you to follow. That's why this ayah, there's nothing like of it, because it's it basically saying in the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, the ummah, it's an obligation upon this ummah to follow the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم as a person. So that means his speech, what he said, what he did, his actions عليه الصلاة والسلام, how he looks, how he walks, how he, anything that comes, that came to us from the Prophet والسلام, we have the best example in the Prophet to follow. This is basically what the ayah is saying. So the obedience of Allah and his messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and the fear of Allah alone, and the taqwa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. Also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah At-Tawbah, ayah number 59, وَلَوْ أَنَّهُمْ رَضُوا مَا آتَاهُمُ اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ وَقَالُوا حَسْبُنَا اللَّهُ سَيُؤْتِينَ اللَّهُ مِنْ فَضْلِهِ وَرَسُولُهُ إِنَّا إِلَى اللَّهِ رَغِبُونَ. See in the ayah, Allah and his messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam are mentioned, and in some things only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is mentioned. وَلَوْ أَنَّهُمْ رَضُوا, with regards to the hypocrites, if they were to be pleased with what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brought to them, ما أتاهم الله ورسوله, and his messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, like وما أتاكم الرسول فخذوه وما نهاكم عنه فانتهوا, what the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم brought for you, take it and follow it, and what he forbade you from doing, forbid yourself and stay away from it. So الإيتاء is to be given something if it's from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and this is in the Quran, or from the messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, from the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you should be pleased with that and you take it and you follow it. So this is Allah and his messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And then waqalu, if they would say waqalu hasbuna Allah, they would say Allah suffice for us. They did not say, or they were not commanded to say hasbuna Allah wa rasuluh, right? This is shirk. If a person says this, he would say hasbuna Allah only. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one that is suffice for us. He's the one that we rely upon. Why? Because these are acts of ibadah. And the ibadah is to be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, and the obedience to Allah and his messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and to take what the messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam brought for them. And then waqalu hasbuna Allah sayu'tina Allahu min fadlihi wa rasuluh. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give us from his bounty and his messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That means also that comes from al-ita, that they would receive from the messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam how to worship Allah. Inna ila Allahi raghibun. Indeed we are to Allah raghibun. We hope and zeal for all the rewards from Allah and the mercy of Allah. Not inna ila Allahi wa rasooli, no, only to Allah. So this is ibadah, and the obedience, and to receive what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants from us, it's from the messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and of course this is all from Allah. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَمَا أَتَاكُمُ الرَّسُولُ فَخُذُوهُ وَمَا نَهَاكُمْ عَنْهُ فَانْتَهُوا. What the Prophet, what the messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam brought to you, take it, and what he forbade you from, forbid yourself from it. He says, إِذَا كَانَ الْحَلَالُ مَا حَلَّلَهُ اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ. If the halal is what Allah and his messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam made halal, والحرام ما حرمه الله ورسوله إذن أو إذ كان إذ كان الحلال. So the halal is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made halal and his messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and the haram what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made haram and the messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what deen ma shara'ahu Allah wa rasooluh, and the deen is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala legislated for the ummah and his messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But does the messenger make halal from his own liking or the haram or the deen? Of course not. وَمَا يَنْطِقُ عَنِ الْهَوَى إِنْ هُوَ إِلَّا وَحْيٌ يُوحَى. He does not speak from his desire. It's only nothing but a revelation from Allah. And also وَمَا يَنْطِقُ عَنِ الْهَوَى, different than وَمَا يَنْطِقُ بِالْهَوَى. وَمَا يَنْطِقُ عَنِ الْهَوَى يعني that means nothing comes out whatsoever. The source of it is not the هوى, is not the desire. It's revelation from Allah. وجعل الحسب لله وحده. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made الحسب, the kifaya, the sufficiency is only to Allah. والرغبة إلى الله وحده, and to seek the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. كما قال تعالى قل حسبي الله علي توكل المتوكلون. Say O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah suffice for me. Upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the mutawakkilun, those who rely, they rely upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. وقال فإن تولوا فقل حسبي الله لا إله إلا هو عليه توكلت وهو رب العرش العظيم. Say O Muhammad, if they turn away, then say O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, حسبي الله, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala suffice for me. There's no one worthy of worship except him. Upon him I توكلت, I rely upon Allah, and he is the Lord of the great عرش and the mighty عرش, throne of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is ibadah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. And also the حسب, وإن يريدوا أن يخدعوك فإن حسبك الله. If they want to deceive you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah suffice for you. Allah will take care of you. وقال الذين قال لهم الناس إن الناس قد جمعوا لهم فخشوا قد جمعوا لكم فخشوهم فزادهم إيمانا وقالوا حسبنا الله ونعم الوكيل. Those who the people, they said to them that the people gathered against you after the battle of Uhud to fear the people. فزادهم إيمانا, that increased their إيمان, and they said حسبنا الله ونعم الوكيل. They said Allah سبحانه وتعالى suffice for us and he's the best one to rely upon. So فالله وحده هو حسب الرسول وجميع المؤمنين. Allah سبحانه وتعالى alone is the حسب, is the one that is sufficient for the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم and the believers. As he said سبحانه وتعالى يا أيها النبي حسبك الله ومن اتبعك من المؤمنين. O Prophet of Allah, حسبك الله. You understand the word حسب, right? That means there is nothing else is needed. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala suffice for you. And also, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is sufficient for those who follow you among the believers. أي هو وحده يكفيك. That means he alone subhanahu wa ta'ala is enough for you. You don't need any protection. You don't need any help. You don't need anything except from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. ويكفي من اتبعك, and also not just the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, but also for those who follow the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, they don't need anyone but Allah سبحانه وتعالى. And this is where the يعني the shame, if someone to be among the believers and he has in his heart that any of the creation of Allah might benefit him or bring harm to him, or this is a shameful thing. When someone belongs to this great ummah of the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised this ummah to suffice for it and to help it and to support it and so on if they follow the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام. But when they don't follow or are weak in the following, then the sufficiency becomes less and less. They become relied upon, they will be given their own selves to seek help from their own selves. They will be left to themselves, to their physical means, and not the help from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as a result of their hearts relying upon other than Allah. So, وَقَوْلُهُ وَمَنْ اتَّبَعَكَ, right? He's saying that, and it also is suffice for those who follow you from among the believers. And this is what he brings the clear meaning of this, even linguistically. And he mentioned an example there. He said, وَهَذَا هُوَ دِينُ الْإِسْلَامِ. This is the deen of Islam. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala لا يقبل الله دينا غيره. Allah does not accept any deen other than the deen of Islam. لا من الأولين ولا من الآخرين. Not from the early generations of mankind and not from the later generations. وهو أن يعبد الله في كل وقت. That, and this deen is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is to be worshipped at all times. بما أمر به في ذلك الوقت. With what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded in that particular time. فهو المعبود وحده دائما. He is the only one to be worshipped forever, عليه الصلاة سبحانه وتعالى. And this is at any time, at all times, and this is where the believers, they receive the command from Allah, worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala like this, in this particular time, forbid yourself from this, this is halal for you, this is haram for you, and they say, سَمِعْنَا وَأَطَعْنَا, we listen and we obey. قال الله تعالى, سورة النحل, verse number 51 and 52. He says, وقال الله لا تتخذوا إلهين اثنين إنما هو إله واحد فإياي فارهبون. الله سبحانه وتعالى said, do not take two gods to be worshipped. إنما هو إله واحد. Indeed, he is only one إله, one to be worshipped, سبحانه وتعالى. فإياي فارهبون, therefore fear me, fear me alone, fear Allah سبحانه وتعالى alone. وله ما في السماوات والأرض وله الدين واصبا. أفغير الله تتقون. And to Allah, what's in the heavens and what's in the earth. وله الدين واصبا. And to Allah, the deen is forever. As he says, وواصبا أي دائما. That means the deen is only to Allah. From the beginning, from the time of Adam عليه السلام, till the day of judgment, the deen is only to Allah. أفغير الله تتقون. Is it other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that you will fear and be obedient to and so on? This is, of course, the answer is no. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the only ilah, is the only creator, and he, everything in the heavens and the earth belong to him, and the deen to him alone subhanahu wa ta'ala, so how can you fear other than him or obey other than him in the absolute sense and so on? He says, ثم قال أفغير الله تتقون. Then the next ayah, وما بكم من نعمة فمن الله. And what's in you from with any ni'mah, any favor, it's from Allah. وما بكم من نعمة, which means there is not even one small ni'mah will escape from this sentence. That means every favor that you have, every single favor that you have, or bounty, or a good thing, is from Allah. No exception. And there is no creation of Allah is mentioned. That means everything is from Allah. ثُمَّ إِذَا مَسَّكُمُ الضُّرُّ فَإِلَيْهِ تَجْأَرُونَ. Then if harm touches you, to him subhanahu wa ta'ala, تَجْأَرُونَ, you turn to him in invocation and asking for help. ثُمَّ إِذَا كَشَفَ الضُّرَّ عَنْكُمْ إِذَا فَرِيقٌ مِّنْكُمْ بِرَبِّهِمْ يُشْرِكُونَ. Then when the harm is lifted away from you, a group of you would associate partners with Allah. When in the beginning was only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one to seek help from, and then they would seek Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's help alone. But then once he saved them, they would associate partners with Allah. لِيَكْفُرُوا بِمَا أَتَيْنَاهُمْ فَتَمَتَّعُوا فَسَوْفَ تَعْلَمُونَ. For them to disbelieve in what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brought for them. So therefore the great warning is فَتَمَتَّعُوا. Enjoy. Because definitely you shall know. And فتمتعوا is not to approve for them to enjoy, it's the warning. If this is how your affairs is, then enjoy the temporary life, because you will know that how you were doing wrong and you when you associated partners with Allah. He said, لكن قد تتنوع الشرائع. The شرائع, the legislations, the rulings can be different from one messenger to the other, or even within the same messenger. كما كان وعليكم السلام كده. كما كان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يصلي أولا إلى بيت المقدس. What the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم used to pray facing بيت المقدس in Jerusalem first before the Hijrah. وبعد الهجرة for 17 months or so. ثم حوله الله. Then Allah سبحانه وتعالى made him change. فأمره أن يصلي إلى الكعبة. Allah سبحانه وتعالى commanded him to pray towards the Kaaba. فتنوعت الشريعة. So the commands can be different. وفي كلا الحالين الدين واحد. And in both cases, the deen is one, وهو دين الإسلام, عبادة الله وحده لا شريك له. The deen of Islam, to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. As the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, the hadith in Bukhari and Muslim, إن معاشر الأنبياء ديننا واحد, الأنبياء إخوة لعلات. We, the prophets of Allah, our religion is one. The prophets, they are brothers, you know, and they have different mothers, and this is how their deen is one. Even their sharia can be different. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Shura, verse number 13, شَرَعَ لَكُم مِّنَ الدِّينِ مَا وَصَّ بِهِ نُوحًا. Allah legislated for you from the deen what he ordered and commanded Nuh to be upon, وَالَّذِي أَوْحَيْنَا إِلَيْكَ, and what we revealed to you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَمَا وَصَّيْنَا بِهِ, and what we commanded Ibrahim and Musa and Isa, أن أقيموا الدين ولا تتفرقوا فيه. That for you to establish the deen and do not disperse in the matter of the deen. Be upon the deen altogether. The deen is from Allah. So how can the deen becomes the source of dispute? And how can they be disunited when the deen is all from Allah? So when they're disunited, it's because of their deviation. This is the ways of the deviant ones. The deen, because it's from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, it's supposed to bring the people together. وَاعْتَصِمُوا بِحَبْلِ اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا. And they should be upon the deen of Allah because it's the deen of Allah. So كَبْرَ عَلَى الْمُشْرِكِينَ مَا تَدْعُوهُمْ إِلَيْهِ. It's great for the mushrikeen what you are inviting them to, becomes heavy for them. Because they want to be mushrikeen, they want to associate partners with Allah. Also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Ar-Rum, and when you hear the ayat of the Quran, it softens the hearts. The clarity of the book of Allah. No ambiguity to it whatsoever. فَأَقِمْ وَجْهَكَ لِلدِّينِ حَنِيفًا فِطَرَةَ اللَّهِ الَّتِي فَطَرَ النَّاسَ عَلَيْهَا. فَأَقِمْ وَجْهَكَ, establish your faith to this deen that is upon the tawheed away from shirk. فِطَرَةَ اللَّهِ, the nature, the pure nature that in the innate of the people that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created the people upon. If the people are to be left alone without any effect from anything outside of them, they would all have that pure fitrah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created them with, and that is to believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, which is the deen of Islam. لا تبديل لخلق الله. No one is to change the creation of Allah. ذلك الدين القيم. This is the deen that is upright religion. ولكن أكثر الناس لا يعلمون. But most people do not know. منيبين إليه. Turn to him with repentance and stay there. وَاتَّقُوا, and obey him, and have the taqwa of Allah. وَأَقِيمُوا الصَّلَاةَ, and establish the salah. وَلَا تَكُونُوا مِنَ الْمُشْرِكِينَ, and do not be from among the mushrikeen. What the mushrikeen did, مِنَ الَّذِينَ فَرَّقُوا دِينَهُمْ وَكَانُوا شِيَعًا. From those who فَرَّقُوا, they disunited, they dispersed their religion. وَكَانُوا شِيَعًا, and they become Shi'an, like the Shia groups. They became groups. كُلُّ حِزْبٍ بِمَا لَدَيْهِمْ فَرِحُونَ. Every group with what they have are happy and rejoicing. That means we are right and they are wrong and so on. This is the deen of the mushrikeen, not the deen of the muslimin. But this is the qadr of Allah that would happen to the muslimin, which shows also that some of the muslimin will imitate the ways of the disbelievers when it comes to their deen and to the way of understanding their deen. So therefore these verses are warning not to be like this, and of course not to be understood from that is like for people to be united for the sake of unity. No, it means to be firm upon the haqq. Even if people don't like you, and people, they would have all kinds of sects and deviations, you'll be upon the haqq that is mentioned. And this is one of the great verses that talks about this. And فَرَّقُوا دِينَهُمْ. And how did they disperse matters of their religion? Is when they invented something that the messengers of Allah were not upon. This is how the ummah splits. So who is the one then to be blamed? Is the one that deviated away, not the one that stayed firm upon the way that was present at the time of the Prophet ﷺ. So this is where the deviation comes, and the deviation can be small or major, but at the end it becomes major anyway. So therefore there is nothing that nowadays, for example, you would when anyone talks about matters of deen, like yesterday a brother was asking me something about people in charge of a masjid, and they're claiming things based on their own opinions and their own desires without having the knowledge of the deen of Islam, without learning the deen from the ulama from one generation to the other. And then the thing is that statement or that opinion, it causes so much fitan then. And then people become disunited and groups in one masjid. Based on what? Based on nothing to do with the deen of Islam. Like if anyone walks in and he comes up with any idea, right? We should do this and do that. Where did you come up with this? This deen is well structured. It's not something that for anybody to say whatever they want. But we have Quran and the Sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ, and the ilm of this deen and the aimah of this deen. This is not something for people to make it as a joke or a play, or they refer everything to the deen of Allah. And this is how the danger of al-bid'ah, how severe the bid'ah is. Even if people, they like it or it looks good and so on, but it causes disunity among the ummah, whether it's in bid'ah in matters of aqidah, matters of belief, or bid'ah in matters of ibadah. And they would invent something and they want people to be upon it, and they would attack those who refuse to innovate in the deen of Islam. And that's why this issue of all of that is because of this. This is what happened to the Christians when they dispersed against their truth, when someone invented a heresy or deviant belief, and then you'd have a group. Shaitan works on this. And another person comes up with another idea, and he makes his own sect, and so on. And this has happened also to the Muslimin and to the Jews before. And why? Because of the innovation. People inventing their own ways when it comes to the deen. But this deen, Allah preserved it, unlike the previous ones. This deen, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala preserved it. So no matter how many different and weird and deviant opinions, the truth is there. The Prophet ﷺ, as if he is living with his ummah, if a person wants to learn, but with ilm, with knowledge, not with wishful thinking. So this is the importance of ilm. And that's why the ulama, the true ulama, those who learn the deen the way it's supposed to be, the Quran and the Sunnah, the Prophet ﷺ, how the Sahaba radiallahu anhu were upon this deen, there's no disputes whatsoever. You know, differences of opinion, some things is not disputes, it's not dispersing the ummah. But they would be upon what matters of aqidah and matters of ibadah, no bid'ah. There's difference between bid'ah innovations in the deen and differences of opinions of misunderstanding some of the text or one text here or there. This is different than inventing a religion for the people, inventing some matter of belief, inventing a ibadah or a way of ibadah, because the bid'ah, as the ulama, they classified al-bid'ah asliya wa bid'ah idafiyya, which means that you can invent a way to make a ibadah that is already ibadah in the deen of Islam. Invent a way to make dhikr. Dhikr is part of the ibadat. It's part of what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is pleased with. But how to make dhikr also is to follow the way the Prophet sallam, and not to invent a way to make dhikr, and so on. So the ayat of the Quran is clear about this. And not to say, well, we are disunited and we have to bring things together and we become sad. Of course, it's a sad thing, but not anyone that would come up with any evil situation. We say we need to include the evil. It doesn't work this way. There is haqq that people need to be firm upon, and to invite, yes, and to be kind, yes, but not to include all kinds of deviant ideas to be part of the deen of Islam. No, this is such a dangerous thing. This is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala entrusted us to be firm upon the deen. Also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Mu'minun, ayah number 51 and 53, يَا أَيُّهَا الرُّسُلُ كُلُوا مِنَ الطَّيِّبَاتِ وَأَعْمَلُوا صَالِحًا. O messengers of Allah, eat from what's pure, halal, وَأَعْمَلُوا صَالِحًا, and do righteous good deeds. إِنِّي بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ عَلِيمٌ. Indeed, I am the unknower of what you're doing. وَإِنَّ هَذِهِ أُمَّتُكُمْ أُمَّةً وَاحِدًا. And this ummah is one ummah. Your ummah, your nation is one nation. وَأَنَا رَبُّكُمْ فَاتَّقُونَ. And I'm your Lord, so fear me, be obedient to me. What happened then? فَتَقَطَّعُوا أَمْرَهُمْ بَيْنَهُمْ زُبُرًا كُلُّ حِزْبٍ بِمَا لَدَيْهِمْ فَرِحُونَ. What happened to them is they teared their matter. They split this matter to be different ways and different deviations and sects. كل حزب بما لديهم فرحون. Every group, they are rejoicing and happy with what they're upon. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded them to be obedient to Him, and this is one nation. Also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Anbiya 92, إن هذه أمتكم أمة واحدة وأنا ربكم فاعبدون. This is your ummah, your nation is one, and I'm your Lord, so worship me. And the ummah قد فسروها بالملة والدين. That means your religion is one, and I'm your Lord, so worship me. بل قالوا إن وجدنا آباءنا على أمة وإن على أثار مهتدون. The millah, or the ummah here, meaning the deen. As the disbelievers, they said, we found our fathers and forefathers upon ummah, upon a religion, upon a way. وإن على أثار مهتدون. And we will follow their footsteps. We're guided on their footsteps. وكذلك ما أرسلنا من قبلك في قرية من نذير إلا قال مترفوها إن وجدنا آباءنا على أمة وإن على أثارهم مقتدون. And this is how every time Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala send a messenger before the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, in any town a warner is sent, the mutrafun, the luxurious ones, or the people of authority or so, they would say, we found our forefathers upon a way, upon a religion, and we will follow their footsteps and imitate them. What is that to do with the truth? Nothing. And this is where every nation, they're so much proud of their forefathers, even if they are deviants. وَإِذَا قِيلَ الْمُرَادُ بِهِ النَّاسِ, meaning the millah is the people, whether it to mean the religion, and if someone says that it refers to the people, أُمَّة means the nations or people, فَالْمَعْنَى وَاحِدٌ, meaning the same meaning also is correct, أي أُدُعُ جَمِيعَ النَّاسِ إِلَى عِبَادَةِ اللَّهِ وَحْدَهُ, that means invite all the people to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as he said, أَنَ أَقِيمُ الدِّينَ وَلَا تَتَفَرَّقُوا فِيهِ, establish the deen and do not have dispute with one another with matters of deen. وقال تعالى وما أرسلنا من قبلك من رسول إلا نوحي إليه أنه لا إله إلا أنا فاعبدون. We have not sent before you a messenger unless we reveal to him that there is no one worthy of worship except me, so worship me alone. As you see, the ayat are so many, right? And unlike deviant or things that you would have to search, the Quran, the entire Quran is about this. And that's why the Quran softens the hearts. And the Quran makes the matter very clear. And that's why this is something that we need to always refer to. And he said, subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَاسْأَلْ مَنْ أَرْسَلْنَا مِنْ قَبْلِكَ مِنْ رُسُولِنَا أَجَعَلْنَا مِنْ دُونِ الرَّحْمَنِ أَلِهَةً يُعْبَدُونَ. And ask those who we sent before you from the messengers, have we ever made other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ar-Rahman, the most beneficent, anything, idols or things to be worshipped? There is no messenger of Allah that called the people to associate partners with Allah. وَلَقَدْ بَعَثْنَا فِي كُلِّ أُمَّةٍ رَسُولًا أَنْ يَعْبُدُوا اللَّهَ وَاجْتَنِبُوا الطَّاغُوتَ. We had indeed sent in every ummah, in every nation, a messenger to do two things. أَنْ يَعْبُدُوا اللَّهَ, worship Allah, وَاجْتَنِبُوا الطَّاغُوتَ, and stay away from the طَاغُوتَ, anything worshipped or obeyed or followed besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And also, وَقَالَ تَعَالَى يُنَزِّلُ مَلَائِكَةَ بِالرُّوحِ مِنْ أَمْرِهِ عَلَى مَنْ يَشَاءُ مِنْ عِبَادِهِ أَنْ أَنْذِرُ أَنَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا أَنَا فَاتَّقُونَ, that Allah brings down the angels by the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to whoever he wills from his slaves, the messengers that warn your people that there is no one worthy of worship except Allah, فَاتَّقُونَ, so fear Allah. So therefore, كُلُّ الْأَنْبِيَاءَ كَانُوا عَلَى الْإِسْلَامِ, all the prophets of Allah, they were upon al-Islam, كما ذكر الله عن نوح, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about نوح, فَإِن تَوَلَّيْتُمْ فَمَا سَأَلْتُكُمْ مِنْ أَجْرٍ إِنْ أَجْرِيَ إِلَّا عَلَى اللَّهِ وَأُمِرْتُ أَنْ أَكُونَ مِنَ الْمُسْلِمِينَ. If you turn away, I don't ask you for any wages of this, my reward is by Allah, and I was commanded to be among the Muslimin. And what Ibrahim alayhi salam said, the ayat of the Quran that talks about how the messengers of Allah, they call themselves Muslims. وَمَنْ يَرْغَبُ عَنْ مِلَّةِ إِبْرَاهِيمَ إِلَّا مَنْ سَفِيَ نَفْسَهُ, whoever turns away from the way of Ibrahim alayhi salam and seek another way, he had fooled himself. وَلَقَدْ اصْطَفَيْنَاهُ فِي الدُّنْيَا, we chose him in this dunya, وَإِنَّهُ فِي الْآخِرَةِ لَمِنَ الصَّالِحِينَ, and indeed he is in the hereafter from the righteous ones. إِذْ قَالَ لَهُ رَبُّهُ أَسْلِمْ قَالَ أَسْلَمْتُ لِرَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ, when his Lord said to him, أَسْلِمْ, commanding him to submit himself in Islam, قَالَ أَسْلَمْتُ لِرَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ, I submit myself with Islam to the Lord of the Alameen. وَوَصَّى بِهَا إِبْرَاهِيمُ بَنِيهِ وَيَعْقُوبُ يَا بَنِيَّ إِنَّ اللَّهَ اصْطَفَى لَكُمُ الدِّينَ فَلَا تَمُوتُنَّ إِلَّا وَأَنْتُمْ مُسْلِمُونَ. And Ya'qub, Ibrahim alayhi salam, he gave the wasiyah, the bequest to his sons and Ya'qub, oh my sons, indeed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose for you the religion, so do not die except as Muslims. And Ibrahim wa Ismail, they said, Rabbana waja'alna muslimayni laka وَمِن ذُرِّيَّتِنَا أُمَّةً مُسْلِمَةً لَكَ, oh Allah, make us Muslimain in the dual tense to you, وَمِن ذُرِّيَّتِنَا, from our offsprings, أُمَّةً مُسْلِمَةً لَكَ. We need to make the like of these dua. We need to inform our kids, teach them that they are to be upon the deen of Islam, and to give them the wasiyah to be firm upon the deen of Islam, and not just to assume that things will be like this. Prophets of Allah, they were making this dua. وقال عن موسى يا قوم إن كنتم آمنتم بالله فعليه توكلوا إن كنتم مسلمين. When Musa عليه السلام, after Pharaoh threatening him and his people, he said to his people when they just became believers, he said, if you truly believed in Allah, then rely upon him alone if you are Muslimin. If you submit yourself to Allah, then rely upon him alone, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he said, subhanahu wa ta'ala, about the sahara, the sorcerers, those who believed in Musa, when they said, رَبَّنَا أَفْرِغْ عَلَيْنَا صَبْرًا وَتَوَفَّنَا مُسْلِمِينَ, O Allah, pour on us patience and make us die as Muslims. the best favor that a person can have in this life is to die as a Muslim and to die upon the Sunnah of the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام. وقال إن أنزلنا التوراة فيها هدى ونور يحكم بها النبيون الذين أسلموا للذين هادوا. That we brought down the Torah that has guidance and light, that the prophets will judge by it those who aslamu, those who submitted themselves in al-Islam, للذين هادوا, for those who returned with repentance. وقال يوسف الصديق توفني مسلما والحقني بالصالحين. Yusuf alayhi salam made dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make him die as a Muslim and to make him return and have the company of the righteous ones. And Bilqis, the king, or the queen of Sheba, she said, إِنِّي ظَلَمْتُ نَفْسِي وَأَسْلَمْتُ مَعَ سُلَيْمَانَ اللَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. I wronged myself and I أَسْلَمْتُ مَعَ سُلَيْمَانَ. I submit myself with Islam with Sulaiman to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Lord of the Alameen. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about the followers of Al-Masih, Isa alayhi salam, وَإِذْ أَوْحَيْتُ إِلَى الْحَوَارِيِّينَ أَنْ آمِنُوا بِي وَبِرَسُولِي قَالُوا آمَنَّا وَاشْهَدَ بِأَنَّنَا مُسْلِمُونَ. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala inspired to the disciples of Isa alayhi salam that believe in me and in my messenger, Isa alayhi salam, Jesus the son of Mary, قَالُوا آمَنَّا, they said we believe, وَاشْهَدْ بِأَنَّنَا مُسْلِمُونَ, and witness that we are Muslimun. وقال تعالى شهد الله أنه لا إله إلا هو والملائكة وأولو العلم قائما بالقسط لا إله إلا هو العزيز الحكيم إن الدين عند الله الإسلام. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala witnessed that there is no one worthy of worship except him, and the angels they witness, and the people of knowledge that he's upright with justice. لا إله إلا هو العزيز الحكيم. No one is worthy of worship except him, subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Almighty, the Most Wise. إِنَّ الدِّينَ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ الْإِسْلَامِ. Indeed, the deen to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is al-Islam. Qatada, he said in this ayah, شهادة ألا إله إلا الله, to witness that there is no one worthy of worship except Allah. والإقرار بما جاء من عند الله, and to acknowledge and to believe with anything that came to Allah, from Allah. وهو دين الله الذي شرع لنفسه وبعث به رسله ودل عليه أولياءه ولا يقبل غيره ولا يجزي إلا به. This is the deen that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala send the messengers, and he guided those who are close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to this deen, and he would not accept any deen except this, and he does not reward except for those who follow this deen. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, after knowing all of this, ذَمَّ فِي كِتَابِهِ مَنْ شَرَعَ دِينًا لَمْ يُنزِلْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala condemned in his book those who made religion that he did not reveal or bring down. أو حلل أو حرم بغير وحي من الله, or made halal or haram without wahi from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As he said subhanahu wa ta'ala, أم لهم شركاء شرعوا لهم من الدين ما لم يأذن به الله. Or do they have شركاء, partners, that they legislated for them from the deen what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not permit. So this is the deen of the mushrikeen. It's all made up. Human being, they made up their own religion, not wahi from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَذَمَّ الْمُشْرِكِينَ عَلَى أَنَّهُمْ حَرَّمُوا مَا لَمْ يُحَرِّمْ. And he condemned the mushrikeen that they forbade what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not forbid. وَأَحَلُّوا مَا حَرَّمَ, and they permitted what Allah forbade. وَشَرَعُوا دِينًا لَمْ يُنزِلْ, they made a religion that Allah did not bring down, as it's mentioned in Surah Al-An'am and Surah Al-A'raf and other surahs. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَإِذَا فَعَلُوا فَاحِشَةً قَالُوا وَجَدْنَا عَلَيْهَا آبَاءَنَا وَاللَّهُ أَمَرَنَا بِهَا. If they do fahisha or a sinful act, they would say, we found our forefathers upon it, and Allah commanded us to do it. قُلْ إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَأْمُرُ بِالْفَحْشَاء. Say, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, indeed Allah does not command anyone to do fahisha or evil sin. أَتَقُلُونَ عَلَى اللَّهِ مَا لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. Do you say about Allah what you have no knowledge of? قُلْ أَمَرَ رَبِّي بِالْقِسْطِ. Say that my Lord commanded with al-qist, with justice. وَأَقِيمُ وُجُوهَكُمْ عِنْدَ كُلِّ مَسْجِدٍ وَدُعُوهُ مُخْلِصِينَ لَهُ الدِّينَ. And to establish your face by every masjid and to invoke Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, مُخْلِصِين. Couple more verses to the end of this chapter, and he says, وقال تعالى قل من حرم زينة الله التي أخرج لعباده والطيبات من الرزق. Again, the subject of التحليل والتحريم, what's halal and what's haram, this is exclusive only to be from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. no one is allowed to make what's halal halal and what's haram haram except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, or what the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam brought to this ummah, as we heard. So the ones that forbade what Allah made for the people as the adornment of this life, وَطَيِّبَاتِ مِنَ الرِّزْقِ, they forbid it upon themselves. قُلْ هِيَ لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا خَالِصَةً يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ كَذَلِكَ نُفَصِّلُ الْآيَاتِ لِقَوْمٍ يَعْلَمُونَ. قُلْ إِنَّمَا حَرَّمَ رَبِّي الْفَوَاحِشَ. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Allah forbid al-fawahish, the evil sins. مَا ظَهَرَ مِنْهَا وَمَا بَطَنَ, what's physically or inwardly, والإثم والبغي, and sins and transgression without the right to do so, وأن تشركوا بالله ما لم ينزل به سلطانا, وأن تقولوا على الله ما لا تعلمون, and then associating partners with Allah and to say about Allah that you have no knowledge of. And the last ayah in the beginning of Surah Al-A'raf, Alif Lam Mim Sad, كتاب أنزل إليك فلا يكن في صدرك حرج منه لتنذر به وذكرى للمؤمنين اتبعوا ما أنزل إليكم من ربكم ولا تتبعوا من دونه أولياء قليلا ما تذكرون. كتاب, this is a book brought down to you, فلا يكن في صدرك حرج منه, do not let in your heart any unease from the book that Allah brought down. This is the truth, this is what fits the human beings, do not be in anything of unease. And this is with every ruling, you know, like also when people there, they feel shy to show something of the deen of Islam because it's against what people are upon. And when people are upon something and because of ignorance they would consider those who are not upon what they are upon as doing wrong, and they might be upon what is wrong and they themselves change to something else, and they would be convinced, you know, the deen of the people is their desires, but the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is al-haq, is the truth from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is what people need to follow. So kitabun unzi ilayka fala yakun fi sadrika haraj, do not have any unease in your heart with the book of Allah, litunzira bihi, to warn with it, wa dhikra lil mu'minin, and a reminder for the believers, ittabi'u ma unzi ilaykum, follow what had been brought down to you from your Lord, min rabbikum, wa la tattabi'u min dunihi awliya, and do not follow besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala awliya, or those who they would, you think that would help you and so on, قَلِيلًا مَا تَذَكَّرُونَ, very little that you would have a reminder or so. So that means people need to follow the deen of Allah. This is what this chapter is upon. Then, just 2 minutes, inshallah, which the beginning of the next one. وَأَمَّا دِينُ أَهْلِ الشِّرْكِ وَمُبْتَدَعَتْ أَهْلِ الْكِتَابِ فَهُوَ دِينٌ لَمْ ينزل الله به سلطانا. The deen of the people of shirk, the people of the innovators, of the people of the book, that it's a deen that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not bring down any authority of it whatsoever. إما أن يدعو مع الله غيره من المخلوقات, whether they invoke with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala any of the creation of Allah, or they would say إنما نعبدهم ليقربونا إلى الله زلفا, as they claim that we are worshipping them only to get us closer to Allah, and they would say هؤلاء شفعاؤنا عند الله, they are the ones that intercede for us by Allah. وإما أن يعبدوه بغير ما أمر, so either they would the people of shirk and so on, either they would invoke other than Allah with whatever reason they would say to get them closer to Allah, or for them to benefit them directly, or it doesn't matter. All of that is the ways of the mushrikeen. Or وَإِمَّا أَنْ يَعْبُدُوهُ بِغَيْرِ مَا أَمَرَ وَشَرَحَ, or they would worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, but without what Allah commanded them to do. So they would make up their own ways of ibadah. مِمَّا شَرَعَهُ لَهُمْ شُرَكَاءُهُمْ, but it's usually those shuraka, those partners would legislate for them. أي الذين جعلوهم شركاء لله, they are the ones that made them partners with Allah. So as the principle for the believers and the people of Islam, that they worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, and they worship Allah by what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to the Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam, to be obedient to Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasalam. On the other hand, the people of shirk and deviation, they either associate partners with Allah with whatever reason they have, or they would worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in a way that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not command. And they would not do this unless they would fall into the first one, which is associating partners with Allah. Because those who invented their way of ibadah even to them, they took them as arbaba min dunillah. They took them as lords besides Allah, even if they don't claim that. So if someone invents something in the religion for the people, and the people follow him, meaning what? Meaning that they treated that person as if he's the lord of the alameen, or he's a messenger of Allah. He's making up deen to the people. That's why when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about the people of the book, اتخذوا أحبارهم ورهبانهم أربابا من دون الله, they took their ahbar, their rabbis, their ministers, their leaders as, or their religious leaders as أربابا من دون الله. أربابا is the plural of رب, as lords besides Allah. And Adi ibn Hatim رضي الله عنه, he was Christian and he became a Muslim, Sahabi of the Prophet ﷺ. So he said to the Prophet ﷺ, we didn't take them as lords, worshipping them, meaning their people, their heads and so on. So the Prophet ﷺ explained to him what the verse means. He said, didn't they make what's halal, halal for you, and what's haram, haram for you? He said, yes. He said, this is how you made them arbaba min dunillah. This is how you made them lords besides Allah. So whoever takes other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam someone to make deen for the people, to make what's halal halal, what's haram haram, that means they took them as arbaba min dunillah. And even if a person is among the Muslims, he can fall into the category of bid'ah or sins, and they have this imitation of the ways of the kuffar. And that's why whoever obeys someone, even if he refers to himself as a person of knowledge, to obey him and to follow him in innovating in the deen and making up matters of deen, they have taken them as arbaba min dunillah, as lords besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because the only one that would legislate deen and commands and so on, only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And this is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he'll mention the ayat. So these two principles of the people of shirk. So we'll stop here inshallah because of before Salatul Isha, and we'll continue inshallah ta'ala. But I hope it, of course, it's something that is supposed to be very clear, and we're supposed to learn this and to be upon it inshallah. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.